Alright, welcome back guys. So, this is kind of recorded a little bit out of sequence. As I was going around doing some stuff, I got so caught up in the excitement that I wasn't paying attention to my segments. So, anyways, this next episode is going to be pretty exciting, but I just wanted to welcome you all into the episode. Thank you so much for watching. I love and appreciate all of your support. You guys are so awesome. The steam that the channel is getting is just super exciting. We're getting more and more popular every day. So, I hope you guys enjoy what's coming up, and I will see you later. Alright guys, I've been running around for a couple hours now, just grabbing some stuff and getting things ready. So I made up a bunch of gunpowder. We still have more metal on the way. As you can see, I've got tons of stuff here. I'm actually got extra wood in there. I'm gonna let it burn just for the charcoal, but basically we've got everything together that we need for some cannonballs. So this is kind of the stuff I've got. Just a little over 800 metal, 600 gunpowder, some obsidian, and some cementing paste. We'll probably have to make some more cementing paste, which is fine. But anyway, so overall we can make 12 balls so far. I cannot believe how much work this is. Mostly it's actually just getting the metal and waiting for it to refine, but we're gonna go ahead and craft these up and see what we're short, and maybe we can squeeze out a few more before we have to start getting serious about getting some more supplies. So let's just... Okay, so it looks like metal and cementing paste are what we're waiting on. Relatively okay with the... Well, actually, we're going to need some more gunpowder and definitely more obsidian. So I believe I have some more obsidian in this box. There's a few more cementing paste in here, but we for sure will need to make some more. We'll plop that stuff in there for now. That'll get us a couple more, and then we just need ingots, which, I mean, we could squeeze out a couple more here, but it's not gonna be, it's just gonna be two. So yeah, I mean, I've been hard at work getting stuff all crafted up, so we can squeeze three more balls out. Oh wow, they take up one slot each too. That is interesting. So, you know, I'm gonna have to do a little more research. Originally I had thought I wanted to do, like, I don't know, 30 or 40 of these balls, but shoot, if they take up that much stuff and they weigh so much too, so let me see here. I can carry probably, what's my weight at? I can carry quite a few of these, actually, it looks like. Okay, so now I'm starting to get encumbered. Alright, I'm going to stick these in a box, and, you know, I think I'm going to craft up about 8 more. I'll get 20 balls in total. Maybe tomorrow, before we go out and do some rock elemental taming, me and the other guys can kind of tag team it and get some more metal. But, like I mentioned before, I kind of would like to... We'll just stick these in this box for now, since they take up one slot each. But what I'd like to do, kind of, I think with the remaining metal in here, I'm going to get some more cementing paste going. But I would really like to get several more fridges built, get our generator going, and then I believe we have a, in our prefabs, yeah, we've got a wind turbine already as well. So we can tell that the wind here is only 40%, but apparently if you can get the wind turbine and the generator on the same power grid, then they will kind of like share off of each other. So like if the wind turbine is going, then the generator will shut down, and then during times when there is no wind, the turbine or the generator will keep things running. And apparently the generator also actually like degrades over time here. So anyways, I'm going to get that stuff going, get some more cementing paste crafted up. What else did I say? We need some more metal. We're going to have to make some more. Yeah, so basically metal and cementing paste. I'm going to get that stuff going, and I'll bring you guys back in then. Alright guys, after much toil, much labor, we are back. We are back in style. So, just to kind of show you what I got going here, I actually still have some more cementing paste going here. I took all the metal that I had left over here, Went and made, what did we make? We made some cementing paste. When I went and got chitin keratin for the cementing paste, I went out to the desert and I also got a bunch of polymer. So I think at this point we can make, I'm not sure how many we can make. Let me grab some gasolina. We'll just get one. I have a tendency to leave these things running on accident, so I don't like to keep more than one on. So we're going to turn this bad boy on and see. Okay, so we can make one. What are we going to be short? Electronics. So let's just pump out several of these bad boys. Wait, how many do we need per one? Oh, we only need five per one. Well, that's fine. We'll need electronics later for other stuff. So if we can get a couple wood, we can get some of these other things going. All right, craft that one up. And one more, I think. That will be one, two, three. Wait, so I've got one, two. Alright, so that was three. We'll make some more of these. Wait a second, that's super weird. Why does it say I have enough in yet? Oh, so we've got two pending and two made. Okay, perfect. So, we got those going. Let me grab a little bit of wood, just a sniggle of wood here, so we can make some outlets, and we are going to electrify people. We are going to electrify our lives. So let's make three, seems like a good number. We definitely want a bunch of these cables, some cross cables, and even some horizontal. I haven't really had a need for incline, so I'm going to leave those for now. We're going to let those craft up. Come out here, we'll jump on Huey, go grab a slurp of water. We just need a slurp. So I think I figured out a better way to defend the area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get Morella Tops or other tanky creatures. I'm still going to set the dinos to aggressive, but I'm also going to have them set to follow. So what that does is if something gets close to this area-ish, he's going to go out, attack it, kill it, but then come right back here and get on tank. So I think I'm going to do that for each side. We've got three Rexes, so I just need to kind of get some other... So I might use these two horny dragons on the side, and then you set them to passive, and it kind of keeps everything to just returning. So, again, okay, see, so there's the Rex going for that moth. And I think when he can no longer attack, he's going to go back to tank, so we'll have to see how that works. Whoa, how did that get right here? Anyways, so we got a slurp of water. Now what are we doing here? What else would we need? What else? I've got all this polymer, this organic polymer, and I'm trying to think. Let's just take a look at the engrams here, some of the later end engrams, and see if there's anything maybe that requires polymer that we can make. I know that some of the guns require polymer. Wind turbine, we can find those. I think I already have blueprints for those anyways. Actually, do I have any blueprints for... here's my weapon blueprints. Flamethrower. Requires a buttload of polymer, cementing pastes. Okay, so we totally don't have enough stuff for that. That's a journeyman flamethrower too, dang. Alright, well, we'll just let that polymer rot, I guess. It wasn't a big deal. It was kind of just an extra from getting all that chit and keratin. Let me get this guy out of the shop here. That should be finished. Now I kind of got to figure out, decide where I'm going to actually put the generator. A little bit of lag there. Okay, so I'm actually kind of thinking maybe out here on this side of the building. I'll get a couple more foundations. I like to kind of have them outside of the building because they're noisy. And so, like, when I'm running around in the shop, I'm not a super huge fan of just having them constantly rattling in my ears. So I'm thinking that maybe I'll extend this out this way and I'll put those things in series right there. So let's grab... Oh... How much metal do we have left? You know, we're gonna leave the metal. I think that's gonna be good for now. We'll go ahead and turn it off. Okay, so we're gonna grab our generator. We are gonna grab, where's our, okay, some of these. We will leave the fridges in there for now. And I think that's gonna be good. And then we'll grab our wind turbine. And the prefabs, here we go. Wind turbine, excellent. Oh, actually we're gonna need some. We do not have any foundations. Okay, I do have some clay made up, so I think we're gonna need some wood, some thatch, some fiber. Running a little low on fiber. And then here we have some clay. Alright, let's see how many foundations I can make. I just want like 4. I think 4 should... Oh, perfect. Almost like I knowed what I was doing. Alright, so we'll get these bad boys crafted up. We're going to set them down. Actually, I'm kind of wondering if maybe I'm going to need more than 4. Maybe 6. We'll do 6 just to be safe. Where did they go? Perfect. Give me 2 more. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Come on, come on, come on. I'm super excited, guys. Getting electricity is a huge technological advancement. It's a huge advancement for the society and for sanity. Alright, so then let's dump this crap back. Now, thatch. One day I'm going to fill all these up. Usually what I like to do is take some time and grind and fill all these boxes up with everything they're supposed to have so that when I do these episodes and videos, I do not have to spend so much time gathering stuff. But... it all takes time, whatever. So we're gonna come over here again, like I said, on this side. Let me, first of all, I just kinda wanna see what this size. Okay, so that's, what does that look like? That's like 2 foundations. That's like 2 foundations-ish. Okay, so good call on the 2 foundations. So let's, for now, we're gonna go ahead and drop this here, this here, this here, this here, and I'm kind of thinking maybe right here and right here. Okay, so this is going to be like our little electrical generating station pad. I wonder if I should put down one of these. I'm going to try this. We'll see how it works. So why would I be able to see how it fits in here? Because that would just be too easy. You know, on the wooden stuff, it's pretty easy to place these just because I kind of want to, what if I go into K mode here and then can I see like, okay, that is actually pretty square. So maybe I will place this, so it's got to decide, do I want it on the edges like this? Do I want it in the middle? Decisions, right? So I think we're going to put it on the edge, and I wish that we could see. Actually, I can do this. Okay, so that's there. That is there. I mean, I like to get this as close as possible because this is going to be running all through our ground floor. Okay, so there. I mean, that is... really, really square, so that's perfect. Then it's just a matter of, well, let me see, how wide were these compared to? So are they like, okay, they're like almost exactly a foundation wide. Alright, so if I do this, again, let's try to get it as perfectly as possible. Wow, does that one foundation look like it's bigger than the other one? Oh, do they all look like that? That's super weird. I wonder if it's just because it's like next to the house, the angle of the camera or something. Alright, well, whatever. Oh, yeah, that is super weird. Why does that one look like it's so much bigger? You know, it must be the K-mode camera. Okay, it has to be. So we're going to go off of this right here. And then let me sink it in this way just a little tiny bit. It's done. Alright, it's in. So we have that, and let me see how these things snap on here. Does it snap? Okay, so it will snap. Oh, okay, so this is interesting. Hang on, so I can snap it. I kind of want to snap it. Maybe right here? Okay, so that's sticking over the edge a tiny bit, but we can totally make that work. Okay, and we can kind of see these along the crack here. So, this is the thing. So here's the thing, guys. Let me do one of these. I think I'm going to do the generator in the back here, if I can. Yep, so this is the thing right here when I can't see. Whether it's... Okay, so you know what? These foundations were a horrible idea. Well, we needed the one to get up to level, but I'm going to just kind of... Okay, there I can see the other one is snapped into place. And then I believe I did use up all my foundations. So I'm going to go craft up another foundation. Yeah, this is horrible, but it happens every time. I wish that they had some kind of indicator that would show you. Do I have anything in here? A wood foundation, perchance? Nope, no such luck. Alright, so what do we need? We need a block of wood. Some thatch. Some fiber action. And then some clay. Let me grab... Here we go. And I'm kind of wondering... We'll make one more just... Just to be safe, and actually that's going to be the perfect amount. Yes. Drop that back in there. Oops. Drop the fiber back, drop the thatch back, and drop the wood back. Alright, perfect. So we've got all that going. I wonder if I'm going to have to destroy... if I'm going to have to destroy foundations coming all the way into the house so I can see where they are run. Because what I'm thinking is, let's go on the outside here and we'll just take a look. Actually, here's what I think I can do. This is what I'm going to do right here. I think if I put these on the ends, it will kind of show me where my snap points are. Okay, perfect. So that works. I can just do this and see. So let me see if I can snap this generator on here. So part of why I'm being a little bit cautious about the placement of these things, guys, is I was watching some other videos, and if you don't get these two on the same power grid, then... Is that even on? I guess there's no wind right now. So anyways, if you don't get these on the same power grid, then they will not work together. So, alright, so we're going to put this here. We are going to throw the generator. Can we get it to go behind? No. Oh, it won't. Oh, okay, that's what I want right there. Okay, so now the thought is that now that both of these are on the same thing. Okay, so we've got, what do we got? 1, 2, 3. So where's our marks? Oops, not that mark. 9. Okay, so yeah, halfway through this third one. But really what we want to do... Not those. Okay, so I'm kind of looking here, and I'm just going to have to... Actually, I wonder if I can... Okay. Alright, we're placing. Hopefully that went in. If it did, it should be in the house. Maybe right here-ish? Yes, perfect. Okay. So, I don't necessarily need an outlet right here yet, but I do want to run... kind of totally just guessing here, guys. I'm hoping that they kind of have snapped into place. And the only way for us to tell is to have it kind of follow them down. So it looks like they are all snapped so far, which is good news. And, okay, so this is where the next one needs to be. So we will go zero. And kind of just... Whoops. And snap, and snap, and snap, and... Actually, on this one, I think what I want to do is I want to do a cross right here. And snap. Alright, let's see where that puts our marks. Okay, perfect. So that's our intersection. Now, did we make the snaps? Everything is straight. Everything is perfect. Okay, so then we're out here, Where is... So there's that one, there's this one. Okay, so then I need to put another section. Is that right? Okay, I think, okay, I can kind of see that one in there. Oh, okay, so I can kind of see the crosses, but for whatever reason, I can't see the other ones. Okay, so then I think what this is going to do for us is if I snap one more of these bad boys... Oh man, or do I need to do another cross? I don't want to have to break up these tiles. Let's see where that puts us. Okay, that's close. I can totally live with that. So, yeah, actually I'm trying to think here. I was going to put a couple against this wall, but I think now... Oh, what is that, an electrical storm? What are the chances? We're working on electricity and the electrical storm is coming. So, I'm kind of interested to see, like, does this thing start glowing when... Enable unpowered auto activation. Perfect. So, apparently during storms, this thing is not powered either. Which is weird. So I guess during storms we just have to kind of take the hit. Is this like degrading? Okay, so it's not going down. Maybe it doesn't go down during storms, it just turns off. But I totally thought that these wind turbines... I mean, maybe it only worked if the storm is happening when there would be power on the turbine anyway. So, I don't know. All this stuff is super crazy, super confusing. I want to know... Here, what if I do... 9, snap it, some snaps, can I get, that should be good. Alright, well there's our first circuit. We're gonna have to destroy these beds, which is fine. And now let's go grab our fridges. 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. Put this bad boy right here. Let me eat a few hunks of meat. And then we will try to get these guys lined up. So let's get into some K mode, some sweet. Alright, I guess it wasn't close enough, so we'll look down like this. Get into some sweet K mode action, and, you know, all we can do is kind of eyeball it. Okay, so that is definitely kicked to the right. Let me swing a little to the left. That might have been a little too much. I mean, I don't know, guys. It's a little dark in here, and I can't see out the back, which is how I normally test. But... Alright, it's done. And we will drop another one in there. Crap, I think I moved a little bit. Yep, alright, well hopefully these next ones line up good. Alright, we'll do this. That looks like it's pretty lined up still. Yes, no. Actually, does that one have a big space behind it? I don't know, guys. I guess they don't have to be perfect. I like to get them pretty close, but... And then what was our last one on this one? Alright, so we'll see how horrible that turned out in a minute. Wow, it is really... I wonder if it... Did it just turn night as well as... Okay, so yeah, it is pretty late at night. Let's go ahead and... I didn't even think about this. We'll gamma up so we can see and see how ugly we made this. Okay, so actually not too bad. I mean, it looks pretty good. All right, so we got all these here. They are currently unpowered, which I don't think I'm going to be able to power them with the storm going on, but we'll go ahead and drop a couple hundred gasoline in our generator. And then, yeah, we can't. So when the storm stops, that should turn on automatically. But we'll just have to wait and see. I really wish that wind turbine would kick up, actually, to be completely honest. So I'm gonna kind of wait out this storm here in the area so I can kind of keep an eye on this, and we'll see exactly how this little generator wind turbine setup works. All right, I'll be RBs. Alright guys, so we're back in. The storm stopped, and as soon as the storm stopped, this generator kicked in. So this still hasn't turned on, but I believe as soon as the wind turbine kicks off, then the generator should take over. So currently we are on wind turbine power. We can see that it's powered up right there. So I'm going to go ahead and run inside the house here. And it works. Alright, perfect. So we have... We finally have some fridges, and I'm actually kind of wondering, what else do we have to put in here? We've got to put the industrial cooker, which is probably going to take up a good portion of the space over here. In fact, I may have to move the preservation bins to right here. So, anyways, we'll leave that as it is at 4 for now, but actually what we can do is we can take our jerky, our egg, and some of that other stuff, and we will make this the meat locker. So here, meat, and we'll make this one eggs, and then as we get veggies and other stuff, we can go in here. So that worked out perfectly, guys. I mean, it's pretty excellent, pretty awesome. I'm going to keep checking up on this wind turbine, because I want to see when it turns off. So apparently, from what I understand as well, that it will actually be on at the same times every day. So it looks like it is maybe going to be what's powering us up at night, which is fine. The other thing I was thinking about, and hopefully it doesn't take anything too crazy, is... What are they called? I thought they were something floodlights or something like that. I usually like to stick a couple of these around the base just to give us some good light inside. Searching. What are they called? So there's the wind turbine. There's the grill. There's their light. I'm surprised. I think we can do omnidirectional. Oh, lamppost. Okay, what do we need? So I need standing torch. We'll learn that. And Omni, perfect. Alright, then let me just check and see what it takes to make that, and that's going to be what we're going to place. Basically electronics. Alright, so let's grab a little gasoline. Oh no, we just took it all out there. Okay. Sorry, generator. We will have to steal a few of your gasoline back. We'll cook up some more gasoline. We'll get that gasoline going. But for now, turn on. We'll make a couple more electronics. And then, what do I need to make a couple more? Okay, I just needed electronics to make a couple more of these as well. So I want to make 2 lampposts. Actually, how many? I got 2 boxes left. Really, probably what I need is... maybe a couple more of these bad boys. Some of the horizontals. That's so weird. I wonder why it... Oh, crap. That's not what I wanted to do. Where's my cue? Where's the remote? Okay, so... Okay, well, whatever. I guess we can have a buttload of lights. Alright, so we'll get a couple of lights, a couple of these going. Do I have... Okay, I have another one of these. So I'm trying to think where these lights will go, and they're pretty encompassing. So, actually, I think I would like to have one... If I can kind of get a good... Okay, it's obstructed. Oh, there it is right there. Okay, so we can see that. That's perfect. Let me grab this right here. And then we can place it. And then let me just see where that puts our... Okay, so if this is the end, if I do... Okay, so I'm gonna try this. Hopefully I can sneak this in there. But let's do like this. And we cannot see it making that intersection. However, I'm just gonna go on a wing and a prayer. Slam that bad boy in there. Oh, okay, so we can see the electricity humming back there. And then if we put this lamp post right there, it's powered, and we can turn it on, and bam! Light to the workshop, baby. I also would like to put another one. Oh, I think I might have screwed up on this side of the building. Because I don't think I can add... I do not think that I can... excuse me. Add these cross sections. See, it won't snap. So, if that is the case, well, I'll just put one on each side. So what I'll do is, we've got our thing here. Wait. Let me check. Okay, so right here. Okay, so this is where the down is. So we'll just run another bunch of those right down along there, if I can get some more of these horizontal cables. And we will craft up several more. Actually, I'm going to craft up another generator. Ah, oh, that was a mistake. I don't need another generator. What I need is another wind turbine, which actually I think I have a blueprint for, to be quite honest. Metal, I think we have all that stuff. So I want to make another wind turbine. For now, not that I'm going to put it here, but just, alright, we're just going to go ahead and craft all these up into electronics. So we need more metal. That's cool, that's fine, we'll get that going. So we've got a couple more of these. Let's see where we end. Okay, so we made the jump there. Just kind of come back here, right in here-ish. We'll go like this, and I'm hoping that that has snapped. We'll do another one. Snap in, hopefully. See if we are. Okay, so it looks like we are snapping. We are being quite snappy. Let's do one more. We'll go ahead and snap that in there. Perfect. Wow, I'm gonna need more of those. Okay. Did I craft some more? I did indeed. Perfect. Alright, so let's see where our last... Okay, there was our last snapper. So we'll go ahead and snap this in here like this. I think we can do one more. Hang on, okay, so that's right there like this. 8. Snap it in, and oh, that is awesome. That is perfectly fantastic. And then I'm going to stick another one of these lights just right in here somewhere, just to give us some nice... And we'll turn that bad boy on. All right, perfect. So we have light in the workshop area. This is great. Things are going good. So I have to say, guys, I've been playing for quite a while here. I appreciate you watching. Again, I love the momentum that the channel's getting. We're getting lots of views. It's super, super exciting. So if you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button. If you haven't already, definitely subscribe. We appreciate all of it. Again, to remind you, I'm trying to get to 100 subscribers so I can get that custom YouTube URL. So that's going to wrap it up for today, guys. Coming up shortly will be rock elemental taming. That should be pretty exciting, and that's definitely going to be in the next episode. So until then, peeps, be safe.